This is an easy way how to stuff small bird. Put some plaster of Paris in the mouth just to dry any liquid. Piece of tissue around the beak, just like that. Then just watch just like that. Now make sure it's dry here from any liquid. You can see plaster of Paris again, just to dry that liquid. This is good method, so the feathers won't stuck to the body when you make the cut here. That's the cut. Again, plaster of Paris. Cut the leg from here. Then you see it's loose. Don't bother to use this plaster of Paris, this is important. be careful not to tear any part of the body, of the skin. It's important not to tear the skin. You see this? You don't have to use gloves. With gloves you cannot make good job, mostly in small birds. You see this? Now you cut this from here. Catch the bird from the legs here. You see this? And cut the wings from here. This is a starling. A starling is very easy for a beginner. The skin is hard. It's important as well to take the ear like that from here. Don't cut the ear. You see? Now we have to be careful to cut around the eyes. It's the most important thing. Eh? See here the eyes? Now you cut the head from here. like that. Take the eyes out. Cut the beak, the lower beak from here. Now you can cut this piece. Now you have to clean all the fats. Cut the head, the skull, like that, and then clean it. Now, just to clean your hands, put your hands in plaster of Paris as well, just to keep them dry. Now it's the cleaning. Always put plaster of Paris on it to protect it from fat. Turn to the other side.
like that.
Oui.
You see? No. Take fresh as much as you can, and fat as well. Now, the wings. You see here? On such beds you have to be careful here, eh? But this is not a problem on a starling. That's it. Now turn to the other wing. That's it. Now, take this bit of bone as well. This is good for cleaning, eh? Plaster of Paris. As you can see, now the tip of the tail here. that's it. Now, another thing important is take the eyelid here, that little bit of skin around the eye, and be very careful to this. You see the skin? This you have to take off. You see like that? Now, and the other one, if you don't take this skin out, when it dries, it can move your eye, the eyes. So they won't be in the same position as you wish. As the skin dries, it turns the eyes either on one side or the other, or another. If you don't take this out, and be careful not to cut the eyes here. You see here, still you have some. If it's dry enough, you can wet it here with a little bit of water mixed with soap. So, that's the first part, as you can see. Now, in this case, I'm not gonna make a body, I'm gonna fill the bird with wool. Important is to be cotton wool, not synthetic, just to keep the position you like to give. Okay. Now, little bit of water mixed with soap. And then put borax on. This is borax to preserve the skin. The same on the other one. Just like that. the legs. And then the skull. Now you have to make the eyes. This is important. You have to calculate exactly how much you need. This is cotton wool, a fine cotton wool. You see? See if it's enough. See? By time you will know how much you need, but you have to practice more than 1, 2, 3, 4. Then you are used to it. Very easy. You see? Just like that. Now we have the eyes, 5 millimeter for Stalin. You make a little bit of sinkhole like that. And then a little bit of glue here. The eyes under the glue like that. You see? When you make the glue, be careful not to put on the eyes which are colored by paint, by common paint, because it ruins it. You have to glue the eyes which are either burned or black ones. But this is important, later you will see. Now wet the skin again, water with soap, always mixed water with soap, just to don't dry so much fast. Mostly in dry weather. Important to wet around the eyes, just to give the position later. If they are dry, you cannot give good position to the eyes. So always wet around the eye here. Then put borax. And then turn it the other way down. like that, see? See this eye, the eyes here, you can pull from here, just like that, you see? Okay, now take this from here, clean here the feathers. From any dust. Now, important thing is now is this. You know, when you fill here, you have this loose. This loose. What you can do first? To dry a little bit the skin. You can dry it with a hair dryer. A good one to take any dust out of it. You see, it's important to dry the feathers here, anywhere. Now, important is, as I said, here you have this loose. So what you can do is this. You see this? Put your finger here, down, like that. And then you make a stitch here to gather the skin together. So that's one stitch. See here? From here to here. About half an inch apart. Another stitch. Here. Another stitch. So you have three. Do the same on the other side. Make it equally. And that's it. See? Now you wet the skin again. Master of Paris. And Borax. I mean Borax for this. Now we have to prepare the body. Just for the back, you put bits on bit together just to make this bump here like that. This will be the back. You see? Like that. Now, you see here? Now we make the neck like that. Make your hair is very sharp and glossy, not too stuck. Now this is it, like that. Take this out, make it a little bit round, and put it from into the skull. To the underside of the beak, like that. Put the neck in. You can feel it here. And that's it. Put a little bit here as well again. Always fill bit by bit. Now you have to put the wire on for the legs. I always prefer copper wire. As well, you have to sharpen here. And go in bit by bit. If it's hard here, you can make can do one thing here. If the leg is hard, make an injection with water. Like that. Just to soften the skin from here. You can see this is out here.
little bit of cotton here around it. The same on the other leg. Now, to join this together, put the plier like that and turn here. The one of the tape. From underneath here, just like that, and turn it to the other two pieces. And then the neck from here, as well, turn it to the other piece. Now, before you cut, you put the neck like that, and see the wire here. And turn it together like that. Now, important thing is how to curve the legs like that. Approximately, you can see the body there, the width of the body. Then turn this little bit like that, and this little bit like that. So, when you give the position, you can move this back or in front. Here as well, to the tail, give a little bit like that, you see, and then straighten the neck. Now, this is for a closed position. If you are going to make a flight position, you have to make wire to the wings as well, but in this case I don't use wire to this, to the wings in a closed position. You will see later. So as well, like I said, the back is already filled. As you can see here, it's very neat. Because I saw here, mm-hmm. And then put the tail a little bit in front and make the body a little bit wider. Hold it from here and pull a little bit here. Pull a little bit here. So the skin will take that position again back. Now, you can fill it bit by bit. Start from by the side of the leg, from one side to another. Always fill as much as you fill on this side, put on the other side, so you keep the balance. Like that. Then put a little bit on here and another bit, a little bit of on here. Now we have to fill the chest, little bit like that. You will see on one side, and then on the other side. You always have to touch the body here, so you will notice where you are filling or if you have any part which is not very well filled. Always feel it. You see? Now, a little bit here. The tail part. Then you start closing from here. About 5 millimeters apart from one side to another. See this? Like that. No. Another stitch. You make a knot here and cut from here. Now you have to fill in from inside here. Like that. A little bit under the leg here. You can feel it from here. A little bit on the other leg. You can feel it from here. Now, a bit on the belly, like that. Then, the other side. Put a little bit here on the side of the belly. Another bit on the other side of the belly. The last bit here. As you can see. And then you can close it. See here? You see, now you can knot this together, don't pull too much, just let the cut easy here, don't pull it too much. And that's it, you see? Now, the leg a little bit like that, give that a little bit twist. Now you have the tail, you can put it as much as you like, and then you can twist here, make it a little bit round like that, and then turn it like that. You see, like that, take the feathers out. Like that, as well from the upper side. Open the tail as much as you like that. press this together and it will remain here till it gets dry.
You can move it either way or another, a little bit inside. Now, you see, pull the body from the side like that, just to make here that hump here, and as well you can put like that. When it's dry, it keeps this position. Now, you have to do is this. You have to put, first of all, you make the tail a little bit down. Put a plier here, just to keep. And in place. Try the wing on the side, like that. Pull a little bit forward, backward. Just to see where you can put the wing on. You see this? Now, what you have to do is this. Glue the wing with the wing here, you see this, put that glue on, be careful not to put glue on here. Up here like that, then the wing like that. See how much easier is that? And then that it's glued to the body. And the other side. And do the same on the other side. Always check before, just to make sure here they are in the correct position equally. Now you have to do glue that again, the other one. Start from here. Always keep the feathers here neatly, eh? Because once you glue, that's enough, that you're done. See, like that. Put like that. Make sure here, you see this, it's a little bit forward, you can pull it a little bit. If it's a little bit backward, then you move it like that. And that's it. Now, before it dries, you put this together like that. You see? It's time to give position now and a little bit grooming and check all the feathers one by one here like that. But that will be later, eh? When you put it on the base. The base is here already, so we can put it on this base. Like that. Now, as you can see, you can turn this like that, this like that. That's it. Then turn one leg. And decide yourself. You can put, you see the neck here? You can put it upside and downside as much as you like. The way you prefer, the way it have to be like natural. Content. Like that. Always pull the feather up here. Don't pull it down, otherwise you don't have good position. You see how neat is here when you sew this? Okay, now you have to fill a little bit from the bead now. A little bit here on the side. Just to fill this part here, under the cheeks here, a little bit forward, a little bit backward, on the skull here. I fill it a little bit, not too much. Just the same on the other side. That will be on the ear, exactly. You can see here, on the ear, you can feel it as well. Yes, that's it. A little bit on the throat. Always use fine cotton. This is shredded jeans. Shredded jeans are the best.
That's it. You can cut here. First of all, you have, you see the neck, check the neck.
If it's in correct position and the same,
a good height you desire, cut it from here.
And then turn the wire. Here you can see the wire underneath the beak.
Now pull the feathers in front again. And take your decision which way you want to put the position exactly of the head. If it's fluffy or neat, any desire you like. Now put clips here on the wing.
Just like that. That's it. Check the other side here. You see? And then, last thing is the position of the eyes. As I said, if the eyes get dry, wet them a little bit, from the inside. You see the eye here? Now, pull a little bit from the inside and give the right position of the eye. Just like that. And then turn the other one. wet a little bit here. Only a little bit of drop can help. That's it. Now what you have to do is close the beak and then check the eyes from the front, from the sides and from upside to check they are in the right position. Like that. Now glue the beak as well. Give a little bit time to dry. And then you can put the feathers the way you like. Underneath here, check all the feathers around. Now you can take the tail up as much as you like and open it as much as you like as well, just like that. Now we can close them out, the beak. Just like that. Just like that, you see? And that's it. Thank you.